island in Southeast Asia, off the southern tip of the Malay Peninsula. The city-state is 710 square kilometers and inhabited by 5 million people. From four major communities, Chinese majority, Malay, Indian and Eurasian, journalism in Singapore. There are numerous journalism and media programs throughout the Singapore for international students to choose from. Journalism and media in Singapore is becoming a widely popular area of study because of the job opportunities it offers. Media timeline history of Singapore. 1930s, 1940s, radio broadcasting begins in Singapore. 1960s, 1970s, television is introduced with Television Singapura. 1980s, local television productions gain popularity. 1990s, cable television is launched in Singapore. 1994, Singapore Broadcasting Corporation becomes Mediacorp. 2000s, digital revolution in media with online news portals. 2015, Mediacorp launches Toggle, a digital entertainment platform. 2016, rise of independent online media outlets. 2017, Netflix launches in Singapore. 2020, podcasting gains popularity in Singapore. Present day, continued evolution with digital platforms and the rise of social media. Timeline history of print media in Singapore. 1824, the first newspaper in Singapore. The Singapore Chronicle and Commercial Register is published by government. Printer Robert Carl Woods. 1832, the Singapore Free Press. The second newspaper in Singapore is established by Edmund Augustus Blundell. 1845, the Straits Times is founded as a weekly newspaper by a group of Armenian entrepreneurs, it later becomes a daily newspaper and remains one of Singapore's leading newspapers to this day. 1876, the first Chinese language newspaper in Singapore, Nonyang Zaobao Nonyang Morning News, is published. 1887, the Singapore Chinese Chamber of Commerce establishes the Sinchu Jitpo Singapore Chinese News newspaper. 1907, Tamil Mursu, a Tamil language newspaper, is launched. 1923, the Chinese daily newspaper, Lianyi Zaobao United Morning News, is established. 1938, the Malay newspaper Utusan Melayu is launched. 1959, the Singapore Press Holdings SPH is formed as a result of the merger of three newspapers, the Straits Times, the Singapore Standard, and the Sunday Standard. 1965, Singapore gains independence from Malaysia, and the government implements strict press regulations and censorship. 1971, The New Nation, a government-controlled English-language newspaper, is launched. 1980, the Times Publishing Group is formed as a subsidiary of Singapore Press Holdings SPH. 1994, the internet becomes widely accessible in Singapore, impacting the print media landscape. 2005, Today newspaper is launched as a free English language daily. 2016, Singapore Press Holdings SPH launches the new paper, a free tabloid-style newspaper targeting younger readers. 2020, SPH announces plans to spin off its media business into a not-for-profit entity called Singapore Press Holdings Foundation. 2022, the print media industry faces challenges due to the rise of digital media, with many newspapers transitioning to online platforms and reducing their print editions. Timeline history of electronic media in Singapore. 1935, the first radio station in Singapore, Radio Singapura, begins broadcasting in English, Malay, Mandarin, and Tamil. 1963, Radio and Television Singapore. RTS is established as a government-owned broadcasting station. 1965, Singapore gains independence from Malaysia, and RTS is renamed Radio Television Singapore RTS. 1974, Television Singapore TS is launched as Singapore's first television station. Broadcasting in English, Malay, Mandarin and Tamil. 1980, the Singapore Broadcasting Corporation, SBC, is formed as a merger of RTS and TS, becoming the sole television and radio broadcaster in Singapore. 1994, the internet becomes widely accessible in Singapore, leading to the emergence of online news websites and digital media platforms. 2001, MediaCorp is formed as a result of the restructuring of the Singapore Broadcasting Corporation, SBC, becoming the main broadcaster in Singapore. 2005, free-to-air digital television broadcasting is introduced in Singapore. 2013, the Media Development Authority, MDA, is restructured and renamed the Infocom Media Development Authority, IMDA, to reflect the changing media landscape. 2015, DTT Digital Terrestrial Television Broadcasting is fully implemented, replacing the analog television system in Singapore. 2016, MediaCorp rebrands its television and radio channels, launching Channel 5, Channel 8, Channel U, Surya, Vasantham, and Class 95 FM, among others. 2020, MediaCorp launches Muach, a streaming service that offers on-demand content, live television, and radio channels. 2021, Singapore's first 5 network is deployed, promising faster connectivity and enabling advancements in digital media and streaming services. Timeline history of digital media in Singapore. 1994, the internet becomes widely accessible in Singapore, leading to the emergence of online news websites and the beginning of digital media consumption. 2000, Hardware Ozone, one of Singapore's largest online technology portals, is launched. 2004, Yahoo Singapore is launched, providing local news and information for Singaporean users. 2006, Singapore's first local blog advertising network, Tomorrow SK, is established, promoting the growth of the local blogging community. The Infocom Development Authority of Singapore, now known as the Infocom Media Development Authority, launches the Intelligent Nation 2015 master plan to transform Singapore into an intelligent, connected nation. 2010, the Singapore government launches the Media Development Authority, MDA, as a statutory board to promote and regulate the media industry, including digital media. 2011, the Singapore edition of the Huffington Post is launched, providing digital news content targeted at Singaporean readers. 2014, the Singapore government announces plans to develop the country as a smart nation, focusing on leveraging digital technology and data to enhance various sectors, including media and communication. 2016, Singapore Press Holdings SPH launches Asiaown, a digital news portal offering news, lifestyle, and entertainment content. 2016, Singapore's first digital bank, DigiBank, is launched by DBS Bank, providing banking services through digital channels. 2018, the Singapore government announces the merger of the Infocom Development Authority, IDA, and the Media Development Authority, MDA, into the Infocom Media Development Authority, IMDA, reflecting the convergence of technology and media. 2019, Singapore launches the Personal Data Protection Act, PDPA, to regulate the collection, use, and disclosure of personal data in the digital sphere. 2020, the COVID-19 pandemic accelerates the digital transformation of various industries in Singapore, including media, as remote work, online learning, and digital content consumption become more prevalent.